everybody, and welcome to It's a Kind of Magic, the show about magic and magical people. My name is Regardt Laubscher. I am the host and also a magician. Yes, Regardt Laubscher. Let's say it together. Regardt Laubscher. I know the name is a little bit magic as well. There we go. Regardt Laubscher. Welcome to episode 2. I'm very excited because I actually had a request. Can you believe it? After one show, someone asked me to do something special. And that is to explain to you guys how to do some magic. Should I do it? Fine, you convinced me. I'm going to teach you guys a classic in magic. Now, because in this show, at the end of each show, we pay tribute to some old classic magicians of the past and also magicians of the present. So this trick is a very old trick. This trick, in fact, is 2,000 years old. It's so old, when they invented this, the Dead Sea was still sick. I know the jokes are very old. And the secret is, there is a hole in this ring. Now, some people can't see the hole, and that bothers me. Can you guys see the hole? Yes, you can see the hole. So it's a big hole in the middle, and that's the secret. I know it's disappointing, but that is the secret. Ring number one's got a hole in it. Ring number two looks exactly the same, except the hole isn't on this side. The hole is on that side. That's hole number two. Hole number three looks very similar, except it goes right around. Now, if you take all three rings like this and you get your timing 100%, you can actually open the holes. Let's see if we can do it tonight. Watch and learn. Now, pay attention afterwards. I'm going to ask questions. That's one. That's two. And that's three. Wow. It's magic. Now, remember, guys, the hole in the middle, that goes right around. And if you go one, two, who can pull them out just like this. You know what? I think I'm going too quick. I'll do it again. This time I'll remove the hole. Can you see my hole? Don't translate that to Afrikaans, but you can see the hole. You can. I'm going to throw it back. One, two, three. Now, I'll do it again, but I'll even do it slower so you guys can really see what's going on. Now, you'll see where the rings meet, exactly in the middle. That's where the hole opens up just. Woo! Okay, now I see you guys aren't following. Let me do it again. Keeping in mind, the hole isn't on this side. Nope. And the hole isn't on that side. The hole is exactly in the middle. If I swing them together just like this, you'll see it opens up. Maybe I'll do it over the shoulder so you guys can see exactly how it works. Who is confused? That's your cue to raise your hand now. I'm waiting for the cameraman to raise the hand as well. There we go. Okay, so how about, I'll do it again, and I'll do it even slower with three more rings. I'll add them. So now you guys know exactly what to expect. So follow along this time. Three rings. Just count and double check. One, two, three. We'll take ring number one. We'll take ring number two. And we'll take ring number three. Now I'm going to do exactly the same move. I'll swing them together and we go one, two, three. Just like this. Three rings linked together. Now, boys and girls, if you guys are watching, especially the boys, I have a message for you guys. Listen to me now, and one day you will remember this. These three rings forms part of the circle of life. This we call the engagement ring. That's the wedding ring. And that's the suffering. Just do this with your dad at the moment. He's not laughing. Now, I'm just joking, all the moms. Anyway, so three rings of life. Oh, just so by the way, speaking about getting married one day, this one is for the girls, for the girls. Soon you'll start dating. Don't look at your dad now, but soon you'll start dating. And they say dating is like algebra. When you see your ex, you always say why. So let's add one more ring. How about we'll do it again, and I'll do it slower. So now you guys know exactly what to expect. We'll drop the first ring. That's ring number one. Keep your eyes open. Number two. And number three. And then, just because you guys are sitting down and watching the show, how about I make a little chair just like this for you guys? Quick question. What do you call the following? What do you call this? No, not a ball. You call this showing off. We'll call this a ball. So how about we just unleash them quickly just like this? We'll take these two rings and we'll try and link them. Remember, guys, the hole in the middle, that is the secret. So where is the big hole? Take your time. Where's the big hole? No, it's in Kimberley. Or over there. We'll swing them together and we'll try and link them. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3. We'll step back and all of them are linked just like this. And the crowd goes wild. I can hear it. Okay, right, so boys and girls, moms and dads, ladies and gentlemen, and all the others, this show is about magic, but also magical people. Today I invited a very special magical friend of mine. He's not a magician, but he is a juggler. So I want you guys to sit back, relax, and enjoy this magical guest. His name is Louis Kaysen. Louis, take it away. Wow, that was amazing. Louis Kaysen, my
thank
hat
you, thank you.
Is off to you already. Amazing. Guys, that's what you saw there, proper juggling. So, Louis, let's quickly just chat about yourself, because we've been performing together for quite a while. We've been traveling a lot together. But I haven't ever asked you, when did juggling start for you?
So I started juggling when I was about 9 years old. Sure. Just as a hobby, picked it up, instantly fell in love. When I was about 17, 18, I got my first gig and somebody sure. paid me to juggle.
Sure.
And I was like, my mind was blown. I was like, people get paid to juggle. So then eventually in 2012, I moved to Cape Town to pursue juggling as a full-time job.
And tell me, when you started off, what's the first thing you juggled? Three balls, most
yeah.
people do or not?
It was three little, what we call bean bags. Yeah, so a starter juggling ball is called a bean bag, and yeah. then eventually I moved to what we call a stage ball. And that is a a hard silicone ball.
Amazing. So moving from three balls, let's say, to four balls and five balls is very much similar, because what I'm asking is, I've tried a little bit to juggle, but obviously I can't do it. Because in my mind, if I can juggle three balls, I can then do a move or a trick quite easily. But eventually I found out that three balls and a move has got nothing to do with one another. It's a total different mindset. Am I correct? Or for you and me, it probably differs. But
The big misconception around juggling is that juggling is almost like a magic trick. So you can pick it up. I can teach you how to do a trick. But it's like you said, to learn the base pattern is easy, but to start learning difficult tricks takes a couple of years, especially juggling five balls. That's a big standard for us, is because I can teach anybody to juggle three balls in a couple of hours, but to learn to juggle five balls, for example, takes maybe 2 to 3 years, depending on your skill level. We do have some kids in South Africa who picks it up quite quickly. I'm quite proud of that. Kay. Especially at the College of Magic, we have some amazing young jugglers who moved up to five balls quite quickly.
Okay.
But that is the benchmark. So if you can juggle five balls, you're officially a juggler.
Okay, so you mentioned the College of Magic. For those who don't know them, it's a school that teach magic and juggling, but you self-taught. Books, DVDs,
completely.
VHS tapes, all of that on your own?
Pre-internet.
Pre-internet. Now, I can relate, because when I started off doing magic, I was 16. I was a real nerd at 16. And books, library books, VHS tapes, fast forward, rewind. That's the way you started as well. I don't think there was lots of books on juggling in magic in the library.
No. We had one copy between me and my brother and one of our other friends. So there was one juggling book we somehow got our hands on. And that's the book that went between the three of us religiously. And it's difficult to learn off a book.
Yes.
Something physical.
I can relate with magic. There was one book in the library. It was a book on levitation. But it was so good, I just couldn't put the book down. So it was just juggling. It's very similar. Okay, so the first time you caught my eye was in, and correct me if I'm wrong, 2010 with SA's Got Talent? 2010?
2009.
2009.
Yeah, the first
going
season.
Towards 2010. So just explain to us that experience. Because what I'm asking is, I also took part in that season. I got a standing ovation, but they voted me out. But you went on to the top
21.
Nogal.
Mm-hmm.
So just explain to me the experience, because obviously when you perform live and when you perform in a competition, it's completely different. I would say performing live is easier than in a competition.
Yes, SA's Got Talent was an experience. It was the first season. I think the semi-final got something about 4 million people watching, so the pressure was on. Personally, for me, I was still a little green as a performer. So the semi-final round didn't go too well, but still a massive learning experience, being on that stage, being, performing in front of thousands of people, millions of people at home. It was a massive learning experience, and it's something I'm proud of myself for doing. And even years afterwards, people asked my signature, because it was on SABC2. They replayed it for like years afterwards.
Fantastic.
So still to this day, I get some people who ask me about SA's Got Talent and the experience.
So is there any other things that inspire you to juggle? For example, if I go and watch a theater piece that inspires me to perform and create magic around a specific story, is there other hobbies or other things that inspires you?
Look, juggling has a big worldwide community. So I don't personally watch a lot of juggling, because I feel that leads to copying.
Okay, that's
so point. I'll watch things like skateboard videos, I'll listen to music, anything. I watch a lot of memes, because the memes for some reason inspires me to juggle.
Okay. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, I never knew that. I thought I knew you. Well, it makes sense now.
Because
guys, on Instagram, what's your handle again?
At Louis Kaysen.
He's very proud. Just say it again. I couldn't hear it.
At Louis Kaysen. Please follow.
So he's got some amazing creative videos on there. And I know he likes to play around with anything. Always scratches around and checking what's going on here. So I have something here for him today. It's a yo-yo. Would you mind just quickly, 20 seconds, just to
Just to give some backstory.
I don't want to waste your time because I don't think...
So I'm the 2017 South African yo-yoing champion.
Which I'm fully aware of.
So this is what we call a responsive yo-yo.
Okay.
So it's a responsive because when you pull it, it comes back to your hand. So this is what we used to play with as kids. The old Coca-Cola yo-yos, Sprite yo-yos.
Keeping in mind, he's from the Vrystaat. So they play Toliki and all those stuff in the Gronda. So you played yo-yo as a child as well?
So this is a modern version of that, but that's not what we use in modern yo-yoing competitions. What we use is looks something like this.
Okay.
This is called an unresponsive yo-yo. Because what happened was somebody basically broke a yo-yo, and this yo-yo doesn't come back to your hand at all.
Oh!
So you basically have to throw in a knot.
Sure.
But because it doesn't come back to your hand, you can, for example, do something like spin it on your finger.
Uh-huh.
Let's do that again. So that's how you get back to your hand. Let's see if we can do tornado.
Yo!
Okay, because it's unresponsive, it allows you to do that. Right
now. Well done, hey? So you incorporate this into your juggling shows as well?
Yes, I do perform yo-yo as well. But we before COVID, unfortunately, we had yearly yo-yo contests. We'll do a yo-yo freestyle, almost like gymnastics, and we'll have judges who scores you based upon your tricks and, of course, mistakes you make on stage.
So just to end off, there is actually yo-yo clubs in the area.
Yeah.
And someone can contact you on your Instagram.
Instagram.
If you'd like to get part of the yo-yo or the juggling community.
If anybody wants to juggle, please send me a message. I have kids across South Africa who speaks to me on WhatsApp daily that I give tips to. If you want to know more about yo-yos, you can just Google yo-yos for Africa.
Okay. Now,
and you'll find the webpage.
Now, Louis, I am very impressed with you. I have a major challenge for you on the performance area now. I want to give you a few random props and see if you can juggle it. Do you accept?
I accept that. No, I accept.
Before you accept and see if you can do it, quickly just sign our book. We have a tradition over here. And while he's signing the book, I'm going to set up the performance area. And then hopefully he can impress us. I think he can. Let's see if he can do it. So everybody, Louis did accept my challenge. And the whole challenge is I have a few random props here at the back, not things that we'd call traditional juggling props. But then again, what is traditional these days? So a quick view I have over here, I have a big beach ball, and I've got, I don't know if you should juggle with this because it just might suck. See what it's... Okay, so we have a few random props over here. I'm gonna ask Louis just to face towards the wall. On three, when you turn around, I'm gonna hand you three random props. He's going to try and juggle them. But Louis, I'll be gentle. Are you ready, Louis? Okay, let me see what I can do over here. Okay, we've got a ball. We've got something. And then we have something massive. It's so big, I don't think you can do this. All right, one, two, three, here we go. Prop one, prop two, prop three. The floor is yours. No way. Okay, stop. I'm looking bad now. Hang on. Give me that. Catch. And let's give you, no, I can't give you that. Let's see if this combination works. No way. No way. Here we go. Now, how is that possible? How is that almost possible? Oh, here we go. Oh, he's doing his own thing now, okay. And that, four! Wow. Am I looking bad yet? I'm looking bad, eh? Okay, well, I'm gonna challenge you really now. I don't think we're gonna use this again. So how about, I'll think about this one. Can you maybe like balance something, like a balancing act? Okay, he's gonna prove me wrong again now. Mary Poppins, eh? Yo. Okay, well, You can pick anything. Which one? Pick a combination. This you can use later when you... Okay, yeah, well, hang on. Is that really difficult?
Yes.
So, if you can't do this now, you're going to have to wash my car, my windows at least. And if you can do it, why am I doing this? I'll wash your car. Okay, are you ready? Here we go. Oh, you want this as well? Very random. I'll get out of the way. I'll get out of this with a shot completely for this. Guys, I'm speechless, which doesn't happen a lot. So, can you use the hat at least? Because was that a mic drop now? Okay, bless you. Would you like your own show? I can pitch something for you at the studio. Go for it. Floor is yours. Okay, I'm gonna have to wash your car, but so it seems. You know what, guys? I think that was perfect. It was awesome. I'm gonna give him a few seconds now to do his own thing here, yeah? But I would like him to make use of the apples. Thinking about apples, I heard the one day, two oranges, they were running down a hill, and they suddenly stopped. Do you know why? Because they ran out of juice. See, that's my part of the show. I'm being upstaged by Louis. Louis, take these two apples. Now, if only the magic man could make another apple appear. Ha ha ha. I am prepared. So, if you can impress me with this apple, you've got my respect forever and ever, which you already have. So, I'm gonna remove myself from my office now, and I want you just to go wild. Okay. Right. Here we go. The floor is yours. So as you guys would remember, in episode number one, at the end of the show, I paid tribute to a well-known magician from the past. And today I would like to pay tribute to a magician named Pavel. He's an American magician, and in the magic world, we perform with silk handkerchiefs quite often. And he was the first magician that I saw many years ago perform with silk. So over here I have a silk handkerchief. This handkerchief is red and squared on both sides. The edges runs right around, and the center is in the middle. Now it's important to see that there's nothing in my left hand. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fingers, no trapdoors or mirrors on this side, and my right hand side is the same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fingers, nothing in the middle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place this into my left hand, and I'll take my green handkerchief and we'll wave it over here. And as I'm doing this, you'll see the red handkerchief is getting smaller and smaller. It looks like I'm pushing it back. Or in my hand at least, but I'm not doing it. You see, it's getting smaller and smaller. See, I'm not pushing it in, it's just an illusion. And then the red handkerchief is gone. I'll do it again, and I'll do it slower this time, with the green handkerchief. Now, the green handkerchief goes in the hand. If I pull it out the bottom, it comes out red. Ha! Like we say in Cape Town, gevaarlijk. Green goes in at the top, red comes out the bottom, going in at the top, coming out the bottom. It sounds healthy, doesn't it? In at the top, out the bottom. Green goes in, the red comes out the bottom. We'll make the green handkerchief disappear. Where's the green handkerchief? Very easy. It's not inside the red handkerchief. Actually, it's inside my hand. Right in there. I have a trapdoor. Yeah, I lied to you guys. It's inside there. Watch here. We'll just do it like this. We'll snap the fingers and we'll pull out the green handkerchief. Thank you very much, Pavel. You were a major influence in my life as a magician performing with silks. Right, guys, thank you very much. Hopefully, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for tuning in. Always remember, keep the magic alive in your heart. And hook up with me on my website, www.amazingmagic.co.za. And all my social media handles are on there. See you next week.